let's just get right into them. But before that, please ignore the state of my nails. I like peeled off the gel polish I had on before. So yeah, I wasn't super successful. You can still see I had green nail polish. Ignore that. But anyway, okay. So the first book I read in the month of October was Dark Rise by C.S. Bookhunt. It's really dark. Rise. And I gave this one a 4 out of 5 stars. I like this illustration though. So this is a fantasy novel, and it was like exactly the kind of fantasy I was in the mood for. The author takes a lot of classic tropes but kind of turns them on its head. So you've got the classic chosen one hero who goes on his journey. You have the strong, silent character. You have the best friend, the love interest, the dark enemy. But the author changes the way these characters are typically portrayed. And I thought that was really fun. The plot is actually pretty straightforward. Nothing complicated. But you can tell that the author is just setting the stage for the next book in the series. I don't know how many books there's going to be, but there's definitely going to be a series just from the way this one ended. It says that the dark will rise. Someone that wants to get into fantasy but is kind of intimidated by it. This one's a really easy and interesting one to follow. Okay, the next book I read is The Last Graduate by Naomi Novik. Let's see, what did I rate this one? This one also a 4 out of 5. This cover is gorgeous. This is my favorite color. I like this shade of green. The Last Graduate by Naomi Novik. So this is book 2. Thank you. sentences, like it's all just in one page. Like, traffic. It's just kind of a densely written book. There's also a lot of, like, magical information dumped on you. And I think it's because it's written, like, first-person, stream of consciousness type, where we're in the main character's head the whole time, and her mind is running, like, 100 miles per hour, all day, every day, and so the way it's written is also, like, a lot. But aside from that, the book is very wry and sarcastic, very entertaining. I describe it as if Harry Potter, like if Harry was the spawn of Voldemort and Hogwarts was actively trying to kill you. That's what this book would be. And you do see a lot of character development from the first book to this one. Like our main character, her name is Elle. You can see that she opens up more in this book. Reluctantly, but still, she does open up. And I will say this book, this series has a lot of representation and diversity, which I appreciate. And it's a very unique story, just the plot and also the writing. I mean, if you've read any Naomi Novik, you know she's also the author of Uprooted and Spinning Silver. Okay, the next book I read was The XX, which is the perfect book for October. Or what's the perfect book for October? Checking on my laptop because I can't remember exactly what I rated each one. But I gave this one a 3 out of 5. Thank you. Actually publishes this book as like this fictional author. It's a very popular book right now. There we go. And I think its popularity is 100% deserved. I enjoyed this so much. It's completely up my alley for the type of books I like. This is like basically six characters that are recruited because they're very powerful, and they're recruited to join this elite society, but there's only room for five, so one of them will be eliminated at the end. And this is a very character driven novel. Fiction I read this month, but it is called How to Write an Autobiographical Novel, essays by Alexander G. This cover, actually. So then there's Alexander G, a young Alexander G. If you don't know Alexander G, he's the author of Edinburgh and Queen of the Night. I haven't read Queen of the Night yet, but actually just bought it after I read this. I have read Edinburgh, and it's one of my favorite books, hands down. So, this is just a collection of essays written by Alexander G. And it is basically reflections on the process of writing, and the hardships and challenges of writing, but also how cathartic it can be. Experience in life as a gay man. He's mixed race, he's white and Korean, and he did a lot of activist work during the height of the AIDS crisis. a professor of English at Dartmouth College. But it blows my mind how someone can be so articulate and eloquent in their writing. It's crazy. He's just so smart, so insightful. His writing is very nuanced and profound and insightful. I'm just saying, like, a million adjectives. But I don't know, it's just his writing. Earlier this year. there's like, of this book, probably 15% of it was romance. Which is fine. It's totally fine, but it's just not what I was expecting when I saw the cover. Story about a group of four friends, their best friends, and something really tragic.